What's going on, guys? This is Mowers coming right back at you again. Enjoying my Saturday morning, beautiful, gorgeous weather, palm trees in the back. Sorry for all my guys up north. I know it sucks for you guys, but oh man, I love being in Florida. So today we're in part two on the Troy Bilt. So thank you for a lot of the comments. Number one comment I got, and from my guys call, you know, my guys calling me, Jason and Doug. A lot of people are saying starter. Okay, so I did have an extra starter. I took it apart, cleaned it up real good, put it back. Show you guys it's working, and we're gonna install it. So I had a couple other guys say starter solenoid, but remember, I'm literally putting straight to the starter. Okay, so limiting everything, putting direct power straight to the starter, and from there it should start on. So if it still has the issue, that means it's not the starter, and then from there we're gonna adjust the valves. So there are two ways from what I've seen to adjusting the valves. So we'll get to that point when we get there, but I'm gonna remove the starter and install the new starter. So real quick, sorry for the wind. Show you guys that this starter is actually working. So just gonna put power to it. You see it's working. Okay, so that starter is working beautiful. So I'm gonna take the old one off. Like I said, it's real simple. You got the two bolts here and the one there for the power. That's pretty much it. So I'm gonna take that off and get right back. All right, guys, so install the starter ready. I took out the spark plug to make sure that everything's okay. So I'm just gonna do a direct power to it. All right, so this is the power pack, a little weak. So I'm actually gonna hook up my truck and put direct power from that battery. And let's see, I'm gonna put the spark plug back on and let's see what happens. All right, guys, so like I said, I put it towards my truck, battery cable. So if this starter, which it was actually freaking working, is bad, I'm literally gonna throw it in the ocean. I'm gonna be really pissed off. So, I got it hooked up, spark plug back in. All right? Let's see, you know what? Let's take off the spark plug. I don't trust it. Are you kidding me? And I tested that starter, guys. I really tested that starter. I'm very upset with myself. I should have known better. All right, so let's put this together and let's see it run. All right, guys, so as you just saw, freaking starter. Got it. But let's try to crank it because could be a wire issue too. You might never know, but let's just double check. No idea what to say. I messed up. My guys recently just gotta double check, especially Jason, you know, and Doug. It's crazy because I've removed that starter too, and I put direct power to it, and it turned, you know, it turned on. the gear went up. I mean, it was fine. It's crazy. But it's all together. I mean, it's running. I'm happy. but yeah, let's put this together and let's take it out for a little test drive. See what happens. All right, guys. So let's see this tractor. Make sure the transmission, everything works fine. Something happened there. All right, guys, so I got it started, right? I engaged the blades, no problem, okay? I put it to drive, did not move. So I got the mower jacked up, and look what I see. I'll turn this camera around. Trying to get in here, guys, hold on. Let's put it up from here. You guys can see that there's a pulley gone, literally freaking gone. So there's supposed to be a pulley that goes for this one here, but on the other side, you guys can see it, it's supposed to sit right there and it's literally gone. I that's just crazy. That's what happens when you don't maintain some of these mowers. It's incredible. So I'm gonna have to order a pulley now. So we'll be going to Project Troy Bilt Part 3 to get the pulley. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. Like I said, I got everything started. It's just the valves. The only thing I see, I have a new battery, but the battery is not that strong for some weird reason. So I'm gonna have to get a stronger battery. I got those $29 ones and it pushes enough, but not as much. So I took off the battery off the John Deere, which is more amperage or more cranking amps. Yeah, more cranking amps. I put it on there and it started with no problem. So literally I'm just gonna buy another battery. Like I said, I gotta end up getting this one too, guys. This is the one that my wife found. She found this for $250. So it's not bad. It is a Troy Bilt. A lot of my friends are cracking on me because they say this is not a really good mower. So but I did see this one for going for like $1,100 in Lowe's and Home Depot. This is only 2 years old. The guy had it, unfortunately he passed away. So it has like 36 hours on it, plus I have all the paperwork for it. So it's actually pretty, I mean for me it's actually pretty good, but there's literally just new battery needs. I'm gonna drain the old gas out of it and let's see if it starts up. I'll send you guys some updates on that on my Instagram. So that's pretty much it, guys. Yeah. So we're going to be on part 3 for the Troy Bilt. Until next time, guys. Like, subscribe, comment. Let me know how you think about this video. Special thanks again, you know, Doug, Henry, and Jason. If you guys don't see that, on Saturdays at 8 o'clock, Pate Performance. He does a live. Him and his wife, freaking amazing. Great contact with them. They're pretty good. So yeah, until next time, guys. I'm on the Mowers. We out. Let's go. Brand new Lamborghini, a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Yeah, yeah, yeah.